you guys. Hey YouTube, this is your girl, Jessica, from Jessica's World, and I'm coming here today with a Peachy Spring makeup tutorial, well, go-to makeup tutorial of what I do on the daily for the spring. So right now, I'm just looking for my makeup. Excuse my facial expression. I don't know what face I was making. I was kind of sick at the moment, so please excuse that. I was just opening up a mirror right there. I'm just wiping off the mirror. I'm still kind of like under the weather, so now I'm using a spoolie brush and I'm brushing out my eyebrows at this moment. I am recording most of my videos off of my MacBook Air, so that's why it's looking like that. And I'm watching YouTube as well while I do my makeup. And right now, I will be showing it in a couple few seconds, I think. I'm using the NYX powder eyebrow stuff. I like that the most because it gives me the most natural looking brows that I can have. It has two different colors. It has a dark brown and like a light brown. So that's what I like about it. I don't like black brows. I like mine to be like brown. I don't think it's like a pomade or it has like this little clear waxy stuff to put on the brows to make them, I guess, to help them stick and stay in place. I don't think I showed it in this video, but I will link it down in the description below of where you can get it from. But I got mine from, I think I would like to say, my local beauty supply store, if I'm not mistaken. That's where I believe I got it from. I think so. But yeah, so right now I'm just filling in my brows. I got my eyebrows done by this lady here in my here where I stay at, and she does very good eyebrows. Well, it wasn't by the lady I originally get them done by, but it's by somebody that work in there. And what I like with my eyebrows is because my eyebrows just look so freaking natural. It looks like I just wake up, like I woke up with instant brows. Like, I woke up like this. Hey, I woke up like this. And you see, I'm barely doing anything to my eyebrows. Like, this is the quickest I ever done eyebrows. And right now, I think I'm taking the clear thing. And I'm placing it in there. I could have sworn I, like, actually, you know, show the actual product. But it's a NYX. It's a NYX one. And right now, I'm picking up. Well, I wanted to listen to music. So, I'm getting my headphones and putting into my thing. Because I thought I was going to actually not do a voiceover. I thought I was going to speak it. So, yeah, but I just wanted to have the music in my ear and listen to it solely. So right now, I'm just picking a song and playing my eyebrows. Because my eyebrows are fleek or whatever. You feel me? You feel me? I know you feel me. But I got another video coming up about this D&B Nation bullcrap. So just be ready for that. So now I'm just brushing out my eyebrows again. And I'm just like fixing them up, making sure they blend it even more and look more natural. At this point, I just adjusted my laptop so it can look, so that you can see me better. And you see, I get hyped while I listen to music. So that's why, and I feel like listening to music makes me do my makeup a little bit quicker. So I did have to go back into the actual pomade. I think I just did the brow, so now I'm actually slicking them hoes down, slicking them down, slick Rick with the lick. You feel me? I'm slicking them down. But if you hear any type of movement in the background, I'm in my bed recording this voiceover. So yeah, bear with me. I don't got all the things that normal YouTubers have, so we're just doing what I got with right now. And so I did just show y'all what it was. That's what it is right there. You see that? Yeah, that's what I'm using. Okay, but I'm still gonna link it down in the description below. Yeah, I'm jamming. Mama told me not to sell work. 17-5 same color t-shirt. Oh, is it bad that I know exactly what I'm dancing to, bro? That's so sad. So now I'm taking LA Girl Pro Concealer in Toast and in, I think in Almond for my eyebrows. I'm using Toast on the top and Almond on the bottom. And this is just to give it that natural gradient effect, the natural clean effect. I like the Almond because it gives you a natural highlight underneath my eyebrow. And the Toast kind of blends in a little bit with my skin, but not too much. So it looks clean, look like I just got a fresh waxing with the eyebrow. The eyebrow game be on fleek. So, yes, you know you gotta have the eyebrows on fleek. So, I'm using the Micellar Cleaning, the Micellar Cleaning Wash Facial Cleanser. And I'm cleaning off my brush because I haven't washed my brushes in a while. So, I need to be able to wash them soon. And so, I'm cleaning the brush. My brush I used to carve out my eyebrows and clean them hoes up. I'm cleaning it off. And it works wonders. Like, the brush, the brush broke. I need to buy new brushes, but since I'm not a big YouTuber, I can't go buy all these brushes. So, yeah, I'm just using what I got. And the brushes I got from Amazon. I'm going to try to go find the link to where I got the brushes from off of Amazon if you want to order them. They were fairly cheap. And it came in, like, a big thing that I got, like, during my very first fall semester of college, because I was like, I need some new brushes because a bitch need brushes. So now I'm just going underneath my eyebrows and highlighting and sculpting out my eyebrows. You feel me? So yeah. So I don't use the product directly to my face. Underneath my brows, because I feel like you don't get that much control, even though it is a brush applicator, you don't get that much control. So I'm just sculpting away. But yeah, since I'm doing a voiceover, might as well sing a little bit. Oh no, we can't be doing that, but guess what? Your girl's turning 21 soon, so yeah, we're gonna have a vlog for my 21st birthday coming up. I got a lot of things, but I'm thinking about starting a vlog channel for certain things because I am doing this natural hair journey. As you can see, I am Team Natural. And see, I'm showing you what I'm listening to. I showed you what I was listening to at first. And you see how I just did a straight line across? That's just to make sure that the eyebrows are evenly done because I like even brows. I know they say brows are not twins. They're not they're cousins or sisters or something like that. But I like to have twin brows. But sometimes they don't come out as twins. Sometimes they be like distant relatives from like a third cousin on the left and like the first cousin on the right. So sometimes they look like that. Sometimes you have them struggles. But sometimes you have them good brow days but they look like twins. Like they look like some bomb ass twins. So yeah. But yeah, I'm thinking about doing a vlog channel for, I have upcoming events happening in my life, and I'm gonna do a updated life update coming soon, and right there, I'm running low on that concealer, so it kind of fell on the floor and really made me mad, because I really wanted that concealer, but, you know, stuff happens, so that's what happened. So you see, I'm just placing it on the skin. I don't put it in no type of order at the top. I just want to, like, get it on there so then I can go ahead and, like, you know, draw them whole, you know, do the outline and all that crap. So, yeah. So I have some life things that's going on in my life coming soon this year. This year is going to be a big year. Like, I'm under the radar right now at school. I don't, like, show myself for real. Like, I'm on a health journey to get healthy, get fit, get right, and I also have a pending surgery coming up, which you guys will know about pretty soon. But I have a surgery scheduled in December to come. It's a lot going on in my life coming up. I do have some underlying health issues that I now know what's going on with myself and why I had the two miscarriages that I did. Like, I now know exactly what's going on. So, that's the thing now. So, now I'm using my concealer brush by e.l.f. It had the name on it, but I had the brush for so long. I'll link it down in the description below if you want to go pick it up. Because this brush is a great blending. It blends out my concealer. Like, concealer where? Concealer who? I don't have those halo brows like people be having. Like, no shade, Altie. I don't do that. But yeah, I don't like the halo brows where it look like you just forgot to blend it. Like you just threw the concealer on and just kept kicking with your life. I used to do that back in the day because I thought that was a thing because I seen that a lot. But now I know that's not a thing. And it's very bad to have that going on. So, yeah, I switched that up a little bit now, which I'm glad because I look back at old pictures of myself and I'm like, what was I doing with my brows? Thought my brow game was on fleek, but it was on weak. But, yeah. Right now, I'm trying to add some extra light into the video because my lighting situation was kind of weird. But, yeah, I was using lighting from my phone. And I like to sing a lot, so yeah. But I now see that I shouldn't did that, but it's okay. We gonna get this together because I don't have a real lighting situation. I'm trying to figure out the best area to film in my room because I got these new lights. But I feel like it's kind of yellowy a little bit now. Now that I done got used to them, they feel kind of yellowy. And right now I'm going in with the Elf Island Primer. Woo! I'm so sorry for the yawn. And I'm priming the eyelid for the eye look that we're going for, which is a peachy spring look. Because it's springtime. I don't like spring because my allergies act up. Me and pollen, we are not friends. Me and grass, we're not friends. Me and the outdoors, we're not friends. Because I just don't do the outdoors. Like, I'm an indoor person. Like, if my job had to make me go outside and do some work, no. Like, I can't do that. I look sad. I look sickening. And then I put underneath my eyes too, so just in case any fallout happen right there, it'll be okay. And also, it's like a primer for my under eyes as well. You know, I just do stupid stuff sometimes when I'm doing makeup. I just be trying new techniques and trying to figure out the best way to get the best application with makeup. And I'm also using that same concealer brush to actually blend in the primer, which I kind of like this primer, but I think there could be other new good primers out there, but I'm just using that because, you know, I'm not a balling YouTuber. I just use what I have, and that's what I've been using. I've been using the same primer for the longest. I did try to do the concealer method, but the concealer method, I don't like it too much. So, yeah. So, I have so much stuff coming up that I can't wait for you guys to see. I'm going to dabble into music, but I'm not going to be like in the studio making music. I'm just going to sing it a cappella or get the instrumentals and sing it here on YouTube with the video. I finally found the setting powder, the Aerospun. I finally found it at my local Walgreens. I am so excited. I showed y'all. I was so excited because I've been looking for that Aerospun for so long. I've been using this Elf stuff, and this Elf, it gives very bad flashback on my skin. I don't understand. Maybe because it's like a sheer white consistency, but it gives so much flashback. This Aerospun, it has a pinkish yellow, it has a pinkish undertone, which I think I may have a pinkish undertone in my skin, which is why it just doesn't flash back on me. I don't understand, but this Aerospun is light, and it kind of smells, but to me, Aerospun smells like the old grandparent, like, powder they used to put on their face back in the day. That's what it smelled like to me, so, yeah. So, I'm just, setting the, whatchamacallit, the primer going up to my brow bone to set that concealer so that it won't move, it won't go nowhere, it gonna stay all that, stay set up and forget it. Yes, I forgot where I remember that from. I remember that from when I was younger. So yeah. So yeah, now I'm going into this LA Girl. I think it's considered a quad. It's like a matte color. It has like these like white, this off pinkish color, and this I call it my skin tone complexion, but it's like this light brown, this dark brown color. And I'm using the top two colors as a highlight for the brow bone. So we're gonna highlight the brow bone and see, I'm showing you what it is. I'm gonna try to find it and link it down in the description below. I'm going to try to start linking things because I don't normally link things, and try to start doing that on YouTube. Or at least list it down in the description below, everything. Yeah. I'm highlighting the brow bone. It's one of those brushes that came in the thing I ordered off of Amazon. I'm so tired. This is the most weirdest voiceover ever. Y'all hear me yawn and sniffle because I'm sick. I'm getting over being sick, but I'm about to hit the gym back soon. But I mean, as soon as I get like a real deal camera, because I like to listen to music when I work out, so I can't use my phone, but I could just like use snaps as showing my workouts and stuff like that, or use like Instagram and do it on hand free to show you what I'm doing. Okay, and now I'm using this Milani palette. I think it's the everyday one, and I'm using that now. And I used the brown as a crease color, and now I'm going in with another, going in with like the brown color. I'm just doing the crease. So I'm going in with the crease. We gotta cut the crease. Going in with the crease. Dark crease, you feel me? We're going in the crease. It's like basically somewhat of a smoky eye, but I like to smoke out my crease because I don't just like to add like a regular color on my eye. I don't know why. I could just like go with straight on pink. The straight on pink like looks weird to me on my skin and on my face because I have dark eyelids. So I just like to play with the dark eyelids that I already have. So I'm just blending. When they gonna get to where I can't blend it no more. Oh! Now I'm going in, I think I'm going back to the quad to get that regular dark brown. Now I'm gonna go all the way up. We're doing three layers of brown, you feel me? Gotta get that to the dark as it can get. Okay, so we're blending, and we're blending. And we're blending, blending. Yes. What am I doing? What is that? I don't even know what this is. Oh yeah, I'm doing tape. I'm taping it out. I had to look at that. Yeah, I'm taping it out so I can get a sharper. So I can get sharp. Sharp. So now I'm going back in and I'm cutting the crease. That crease is so dead, you need to cut it. That crease is so dead, you need to cut it. Cut it, ooh, cut it, wow, cut it, whoop, cut it, yeah, cut it out, cut it, whoop, cut it, yeah, cut it out. That crease is too dull, you need to cut it. That crease is too dull, you need to cut it. Cut the crease with the brown, make it look real nice. You know, we gotta cut that crease. Now we're getting deep. We getting deep in a little sparkle with the sparkly deep brown. And we keep cutting that crease. You know, we darken it. Put a little deeper color. And we darken it. Now I feel like right now, I feel like I shouldn't have actually did like my lightest concealer to put on there so the color could pop. But, you know, it's just a go-to. And I'm trying to hurry up with this video because I was getting tired. So now I'm just going to, what I shouldn't have did right now is use a concealer so that I was trying to make it to where the actual color could pop, the peachy color, but we're gonna see that it wasn't a good idea to do that, but you know, trial and error. Okay, so now we're going in with like a little light, with like another color that came in this palette, it was like a skin complexion, like a nude color. And then we're gonna go in with the pink color next to the new color. Voiceovers are worse than just doing it while the video's playing, but I just want to listen to music. And I don't want to get no copyright infringement and can't get my coins. Like, even though I'm not getting any coins, I just don't want to do no copyright since I'm a small time YouTuber. And now I'm going in with this Milani, this rouge color. And that's the color that I'm using to get that that peachy rose color. You can't barely see with my skin complexion, which I hate that I didn't use the filler method. I see lots of people do. But it's okay. We switched to like 3 brushes doing this to try to make it show and be glittery. We tried. So yeah, I'm just adding that color, and I like to do my eye makeup and like all my eye products first before I do my foundation, because I feel like I have more control and I'm able to actually make everything look nice and neatly, and if there's any fallout, I can easily just wipe it off and apply the foundation. But when you put the foundation first, it's like fallout just be on your foundation, and it's like if you don't want the all over glittery look, then it's like you just messed up because you're gonna have that all over glittery going on. So now I'm applying this Shine Killer primer. It kind of works and it kind of doesn't. I guess it depends on my weather here, because sometimes I actually sweat a lot. So now I'm just priming the face. And this stuff is like, I have a weird consistency that I don't like. And I don't really use foundation right now. I'm using the concealer that I was using for my under eye stuff. I use that brand, and I use it in, I think I use it in Toast. Like over the eye, yeah, I used the face and Toast, but over the eye I was using Fawn. And I use that. I use concealer as foundation because I feel like this is the only thing that matches my skin completely, and it just gives me the greatest coverage. And somehow it looks natural at the same time, which really is weird. So I go down my nose. Highlight these. I have like a little dark spot area from like an old acne scar that just hasn't went away. So now I'm using my Beauty Blender, and I'm so sorry, but my Beauty Blender is really dirty. And you can tell I'm like so overdoing this makeup now that I'm just like rubbing it real fast and I'm like blending it fast. But normally, if I was just going out that night, I wouldn't do it this fast, but I'm trying to hurry up and get this done because I'm ready to stop filming. I'm ready to go to bed because I'm still kind of sick. I was starting off my sickness there. And if y'all want a room tour, I could do a room tour because I think I'm going to be settled of how I want my room to look right now. But yeah, I might have to add one more thing into my room, but that'll be somewhere later down the line. Now I'm just blending. That's the only thing I don't like about putting on foundation is all the blending. Because you don't want people to know you're wearing foundation. You just want it to look natural. And you gotta blend down the neck so you don't have the line of demarcation, what I didn't know back in the day. And now I'm using the almond for my eyes to give it some brightness. Ooh. That's why back in the day. So now I'm adding more light again with my phone. Ooh, okay, I'm sorry, that was a big one. I shouldn't have blown my nose, but I didn't want to blow it on the recording. And then I'm highlighting down the bridge of my nose and up there and on the bottom. I don't do the Cupid's bow because I don't like to do that too often because I sweat around my mouth. I don't know why, but I sweat around my upper lip. And I'm just blending out the concealer. Blending, 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 blending. Blending. I blend a little bit down my nose. I'm just blending out everything. Make sure everything is well put together. Okay, so now we're going to go in with the air sponge. We're going and make the whatchamacallit, the sponges I'm using are Real Technique sponges. And I said, at this moment, I think I realized I put too much underneath there because I didn't really go over the board with the highlighting. That's why only on one side it's a lot and it goes out that far. And I went back over to the other side and made it go a little farther so it could even out. So now I'm baking and I'm going to go ahead and line the eye, which I didn't do because I haven't been doing liner for the longest, so it kind of looked weird at the end because I haven't done liner in a while. I'm using the e.l.f. liquid liner, and I literally just stopped showing y'all product at this point in time. Okay, and I'm using e.l.f. mascara. I like this mascara a lot. Look at those eyebrows, though. Eyebrows on fleek. This day, I don't know what was going on with my eyebrows. My eyebrows normally look longer than this. I think because I just was ready to be done. And they just like were ready to be done too. So I just kept trying to make them look lengthened. But I don't like to use like lashes. Right now, just trying to force these lashes to show, and I'm not really baking because normally if I really was baking it'd be longer than this, but it's for video purposes and I don't know how to like speed up things within the video. And now I'm gonna contour with that brown shadow contour to the girl contour up there, the temple contour on my cheek. I normally do it like a very like harsh contour, but since this is like a go-to every day, you don't want to do it too harsh. Kind of like a bruise. And I'm gonna go in with, I think this is the Benefit Hoola bronzer I'm looking for my nose, to carve my nose out. Wiping off the brush again. Ooh. Yep, going in with the Benefit Hoola bronzer. Excuse the glitter. Glitter fell into my makeup thing. Now I'm just going to, you know, chisel out the nose. We don't want to use a dark one because I don't like to use dark on my nose. When I use a darker color on my nose, it looks kind of weird. So, yeah, we just carved out that nose. Now we're going to go in with a big foundation blending brush. And I'm going in with my foundation that I use on my face, and I think it was CoverGirl, or it may have been Rimmel, but I believe it was CoverGirl. And I'm just blending the face, just like, you know, going over, just wiping off the powder. We don't want it to be like too highlighted, we just want it to set and make sure that the highlighting stuff don't go.